How's it going, everyone? Prestige here. Got a quick, chill commentary for you today, playing some Demolition on Nuketown 2025. Now, normally, I don't upload Demolition gameplays, but I do want to talk about the double XP weekend that we just had and the Nuketown 2025 playlist. I only get one death in this gameplay, and that was the one you just seen there. I killed myself with my own C4, ended up giving the enemy an assisted suicide, and it was just overall super embarrassing. But I hope you enjoy the gameplay and commentary. Let's talk a little bit about Nuketown 2025 in general. When the Nuketown playlist comes around, it's a Nuketown 24/7 playlist, and it's one of the most popular playlists in Call of Duty Black Ops 2. I believe this weekend, it was so popular there was about 90 to 100,000 people playing concurrently in the same playlist, and that's a lot of people. That's almost half of the amount of people that play Call of Duty Black Ops 2 online at any given time. Now, normally, Team Deathmatch is one of the most played game modes in Black Ops 2, but Nuketown 2025 totally smashed that record, and there's just a huge mosh pit of game modes that you can play. You can play Kill Confirm, Domination, Demolition. I don't know if Search... Actually, I think Search and Destroy is still in there, and I don't know if Capture the Flag is still in there or not, but there's been just so many changes to the game mode, it's hard to keep track of. But there's so many people playing it at once, you're bound to get into games that are already in progress, and myself and Reverend Saint, actually, we've been hopping from game to game trying to find a game that hasn't already started. And generally, when you get into one of these games, you're usually found on the enemy team that's losing, and Lodestars are just piling the missiles down onto the map. And this is such a tiny map that Lodestars, dogs, swarms will mess you up, especially if you call in dogs and a swarm at the same time. Dogs will weed out your enemies that are in the house. Swarm will take out anyone that's spawning in. And it's just really crazy and hectic at times. So here's my question to you guys. If there was a Nuketown 24/7 playlist and it was always there, would you play it if they disabled the kill streaks? Now that's an awesome question, I think, because a lot of people only play Nuketown to get the kill streaks. And I'm talking to get Lodestars, to get VTOL warships, dogs, swarms. And that really does take a lot of flavor out of playing the game in general. And I see a lot of people that come in and just completely ignore playing the objective, especially when it comes down to playing Domination, or Demolition, I mean, sorry. Demolition is one of those game modes where you need to defend your bomb and then you need to plant the bomb. And it always comes down to the point where people won't plant the bomb. They're so worried about getting into the enemy spawn and just spawn killing them that they forget that there's an objective to play, and then games just last a whole bunch longer than they need to. Now that might piss off a lot of people because, hey, I'm going for a huge 100 kill streak, or I'm going to try to get as many kills as I can in this game of Demolition because I'm going to spawn kill people. That doesn't really make for cool gameplays. Gameplays like this are what make good gameplays. Running in, planning the objective, doing what you have to do, staying under the radar of the enemy, trying to just get in there without being seen and just plant like a sneaky ninja. That makes for an awesome gameplay, and you're about to see a super rush here planning both of these objectives. My teammates, they weren't doing anything. The only thing that they were doing, which I'm actually proud of, is they were defending me when I was planting the bombs. Not many people will do that. If you go, let's just say you go in solo on Nuketown 2025, it always seems like people just want to spawn kill. So if you're trying to plant the objective in Demolition, you're most likely going to die because no one's watching you. They're too busy trying to watch the spawn, and that's... It comes down to it and makes it really, really hard to play this game, or Nuketown 2025 in general. So, back to the general question that I had, would you play Nuketown 24/7 if it was in its own playlist? So, like say if there was a Nuketown Domination, a Nuketown Demolition, would you play the Nuketown 24/7 playlist if there were no kill streaks enabled or score streaks? So that means you couldn't get UAVs, you couldn't get lightning strikes, you couldn't get dogs, swarms, VTOLs, or Lodestars. I think that's an awesome thing. I would totally vote for yes. The only reason I would say yes to playing this without the kill streaks is it would be a lot more gun-on-gun action. You would be able to get and earn a lot more points than any other game mode. Like, generally speaking, when I was prestiging and we had that huge double XP week, that's when I got most of my prestiges done, playing Nuketown 2025, and it was Nuketown 24/7, but it was only available to people that had downloaded the map already. It wasn't available to people that didn't get the Hardened Edition, so I thought that was pretty cool at first. So a lot of people got their time in on Nuketown before everyone was able to download it and play it. But guys, it's winding down to the end of the video. I ended up picking up this KSG and just going to town on the enemies. Picking up the Relentless Medal. I was so close to getting the Nuke Medal. But it's just one of those things out of hand. But once again, guys, down below in the comment section, would you play Nuketown 24/7 if there were no kill streaks enabled? I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please drop a like. If not, that's cool. And keep in mind, I am on the road to 150,000 subscribers. If you'd like to hit that subscribe button, please feel free to do so. And until next time, I am out. Peace.